day to my respected panels. I'm Tarrsini Mahadevan. Today I'll be presenting my project under the cluster of biotechnology. My research work is titled Practicability of Lignocellulosic Waste Composite in Controlling Air Pollution from Leaves Litter Through Bioethanol Production. My presentation will include sections as displayed. Before I proceed further into my presentation, I would like to briefly give an introduction on my research work. My research work could be described as the implementation of lignocellulosic biomass for bioethanol production. Basically, the lignocellulosic biomass is made up of cellulose and hemicellulose that can be converted into fermentable sugar to produce bioethanol. As for the problem statement, the initial problem statement identified was the undeniable dependency on the depleting energy source fossil fuel. Hence, an alternative energy source was sought and bioethanol was developed. Bioethanol is a suitable alternative as it is a clean renewable energy. However, a follow-up problem arose when the bioethanol was produced from food crops such as potato, wheat and corn. This is because primary bioethanol caused food versus fuel competition. So, secondary bioethanol production was introduced. This production originated from non-edible biomass such as lignocellulosic waste. As forementioned, this raw material has holocellulose component that contributes to feasible bioethanol production. Finally, the main problem statement is addressed and the ideology of selecting mango leaves for this project is justified. In Malaysia, mango plantations are abundantly available for various purposes. This plantation produces limitless mango leaf waste during the harvest season. These leaves are commonly disposed by open burning and eventually leads to environmental pollution. So, as a solution, I designated my research work to utilize the mango leaves, a lignocellulosic biomass with high holocellulose content, to produce bioethanol. In other words, this waste to wealth project is an efficient measure to manage the mango leaves left over. Now, let's look into the process flow. The process starts off with lignocellulosic biomass preparation of three different mango varieties, which are Harumanis, Chakanan, and Sunshine, followed by moisture and biochemical composition analysis. As a validation step, the screening of bioethanol production suitability is conducted, whereby the enzymatic hydrolysis efficiency and bioethanol yield is evaluated. This is the mango leaf preparation process. The biomass is collected, then washed and dry, next weighed, and then grinded, and finally sieved to produce mango leaf powder. After the drying process, the moisture analysis is conducted. Next, biochemical composition analysis is initiated. The component quantified include extractive, hemicellulose, lignin, ash, and cellulose. In the screening process, the powdered biomass is added with the hydrolase for the enzymatic hydrolysis. Then the content is filtered. The filtrate is used to test the conversion efficiency of holocellulose into fermentable sugar. Next, the remaining filtrate is fermented with yeast to produce bioethanol. Lastly, the yield of the bioethanol is quantified. As for the product performance, undoubtedly, Harumanis is chosen to be the most apt source for bioethanol production compared to Sunshine and Chakanan. This is because, in terms of biochemical composition, the former biomass has the highest holocellulose content. As a precise conversion of holocellulose content could favor a bioethanol production. As tabulated here, Harumanis mango leaves also have recorded the highest enzymatic hydrolysis efficiency and bioethanol yield. This data further justifies the previously elaborated product performance. Based on this presentation, it can be said that this innovation could be a sustainable alternative to replace other energy sources. These are the publications related to this research work. To wrap up, I would like to acknowledge the following parties listed here for their contributions. Thank you very much for your time.